Hey, welcome to The Perspective today. I'm Mike Sherbino. Delighted that you're with us. We have a special guest in the studio who I'm going to introduce to you in a couple of minutes. You ever hear the expression, walk on water? What does it mean? Well, it's a reference to the time when Peter was in a boat and he saw Jesus coming and said, if you are really the Messiah, bid me come to you on the water. And Jesus said, okay, get out of the boat and walk on the water. And that's exactly what happened. But the problem was this. Peter started to look around and he saw the waves and he began to think, oh my goodness, is this really happening? He had taken the step of faith, but then as he looked around and he saw everything about him, he thought, I'm going to go down. And he called out to Jesus and said, Jesus, will you save me? And Jesus reached out his hand and he drew him to himself. It's easy to criticize Peter because he had that moment of saying, oh, of real doubt. But I love the story because he stepped out of the boat. And if you're going to walk on water, you got to step out of the boat. But you know, when you do that, when you take the step of faith, when you do the thing you know you need to do, and you're not sure, oh, who's going to be there to support me? Who's going to be there to help me? Well, the Lord is there. But here at The Perspective, I have a special gift for you. And by God's grace, we're going to make it available every month. It's a daily devotional to help you walk on water, to get your life in tune with God's word, to understand the promises in God's word, and to help you to take some time to commit your day to the Lord. You can write to me, prayer@theperspective.tv. Give me your name and address, and we will mail you this book. This is September's copy. October is coming. I'm looking forward already to October. But you know what? Start right now, and we'll send it out to you to help you to walk on water. Now, one of the reasons I'm talking about walking on water today is that I have a guest with us. He's an incredible musician, a Nashville recording star. He's also the worship pastor at our church. So it's like the best of both worlds. And thankfully, he doesn't like bluegrass music. But all that aside, he has just written a brand new song called Walk on Water. And we're going to hear the acoustic version later on in the program. Kristin, love you, man. So glad you're back with us today. Yeah, you got more bling on than my wife, and that's always exciting to see what's going to happen. It's the way of a musician, right?
Yeah, I was just born this way, apparently.
Okay, talk to us just in a nutshell about Walk on Water. What's the song all about? And then we want to go back and retrace some of your steps.
Well, the song's about need a miracle, and like you referenced really well about Peter in the boat, and just... looking to Jesus to knowing something's not complete yet. I need more, God. I need to get to the other side. And Peter stepped out of the boat in faith. And just in my life, I've gone through different ups and downs and just recognized that it's not finished yet. I need to step out. I need more. I'm waiting for a miracle. And recently, I've been referencing this live on stage. Our bass player has been diagnosed with cancer and he's fighting. And he joined us back on stage last week. And I'm just saying we're waiting for a miracle for Scott, too, our bass player, and just believing that God can do what he said he could do in his word. So it's about miracles.
So many of us, even at this moment and that are watching, are asking God for a miracle. But all of us at different times in our life turn to God and say, God, we need you. And I remember a man named Bill Prankard prayed for my wife once when she was battling cancer. And he said, and her name is Terry, of course, but he said, Lord, I'm not asking for a blessing for Terry. I'm asking for a miracle. And I just want to say today that as you're watching the program, if you need a miracle, I'm not trying to play with your emotions, but I believe in the power of prayer. Yeah. And when you hear Chris's story in a moment, you're going to understand why. But call the number 855-910-6297. We have a prayer team that is willing to pray with you, to encourage you, to ask God to do the miraculous, or you can write to me, prayer@theperspective.tv. Share your request so that I can be praying specifically for you. Kristin, we talk about the miracle in your life, and I want you to unpack it in a minute, but take us back. You've been playing guitar and singing for a long, long time, and just give us a bit of the picture, some of the you know, you started off high and then boom, crashed.
Yeah. So I started as a teenager playing in a Christian rock band.
I can't imagine.
called Fear of God. And we toured North America, and we played a lot of the Aquaria, the fire events back in the 90s and early 2000s. So there was like 3,000 to 5,000 to 10,000 people a night at some of these shows. And this song reference, I won't shine so bright, but time dulled this light. I fought the good fight, but I feel wounded. And you know, it doesn't matter where you're planted, whether it's church or in the world, you're going to get hurt. You're going to have disappointments. And I had all these big highs, and then all of a sudden there was no stage anymore. We kind of stopped playing with that band, and I had to kind of reinvent myself again. And I felt really kind of lost and know where I fit in. I didn't know my identity anymore.
Did you kind of feel like it was phony in some ways, the whole thing, or was there legit parts?
Well, we had some really great moments with that band, you know, but the music business is quite ruthless. And if you put your hope in that, you're going to be very disappointed. And you empty promises and whatnot. Even though we did some great things, I had to start over again. And I felt pretty broken. And I, through sharing my story with you before a few times, just had some traumatic experiences that left me pretty hurting and in need of God, in need of miracle.
How did you know you'd come to the end of yourself?
I looked in the mirror and I didn't recognize myself anymore. And that was even as of last year, I said, God, I need help. Help. Didn't like what I'd become on the inside and on the outside. And so I had to make some changes.
Can you unpack that a little bit more when you say you didn't like, when you looked in the mirror, you didn't recognize yourself? What does that mean?
Yeah, I guess so. I'd used drugs and alcohol in the past to numb what was going on in my head. And through different abuses in my life, physical abuse, sexual abuse, spiritual abuse, I didn't realize that I was numbing the effects of that inside. And the numbing agents I used to take a toll on my body, I'd gained weight, just swollen eyes. It was a lot of pain physically. You know, I was angry. A lot of things like that, even through COVID. Being a musician, I wasn't able to work for years and lost all my income, lost all my savings. And I just didn't like who had come. And I cried out to God to help. I remember specifically, you know, sometimes when you don't know what to say, something so simple as Jesus, help. He knows what we need. And that was the start of a transformation and coming back to him. And I've just seen so many great things happen because of him and because of his grace. Because he loves us. He says he leaves the 99 to find the one. And I was the one. I'm here today because of that. His grace.
So as people are listening right now, and we turn to all sorts of things to numb the pain, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we work harder. We work longer. If we can earn more, buy more, or get more, we think we're going to be happy. What advice would you give them?
Well, yeah, I did some therapy for a couple of years, which helped. But it was when I had this morning routine, as we've talked about. I wake up every morning, have not missed a day. And I have these promises that God has for me in his word and these affirmations I read to myself. And I read that every morning, and then I open God's word in a couple of different chapters, different books in the Bible. And every morning I read these chapters, and I read these affirmations and promises from God's word, and then I pray. I worship on, and setting my morning up, it clears my mind, helps me to hear what he wants me to do for the day. I know that if I can just do that, at least I'm going to have a good day, no matter what happens. And it just, I've been really consistent, really always had to fight for that time. And if I have to be at the house at 6 o'clock, well, guess what? I get up at 5 a.m. because it's that important to me.
Wow.
And, you know, as you know, when God is healing your mind and your heart, you know, I've lost a lot of weight in the last year just by, I think...
A healthy discipline.
Yeah.
Walking with Jesus.
Yeah.
We're going to talk more about that discipline. We're going to be unpacking a little more of your story and hearing about the song you're going to sing for us in a few minutes. Stay with us here on The Perspective. And if at any time you want someone to talk to pray with you, call 855-910-6297. We'll be right back with Kristin Nicholls. Thank you. Hey, welcome back to the Perspective. I'm here again with my good friend Kristin Nicholls, who has recently written a song. You're going to hear it in just a couple of minutes, called Walk on Water. But Kristin, before we hear the song, and I really love this rendition of it because you're going to do it with your acoustic guitar, which is so beautiful. People are going to be able to get the copy of this. They're going to be able to listen to it with the full band and the whole thing. But man, we just kind of get the raw, unedited version, and it is so good. It is just so good. Getting to that place of being where we can just enjoy this again. You were delivering those kind of goods a couple of years ago, were you?
Still, I feel kind of washed up. But I've had a resurgence as our band has gone country. Hence my hats and my cowboy boots.
I'm trying hard.
You gotta wear the outfit. But I just have a resurgence, and I feel like I've got something to say again.
Just before I went to the break, you talked about some daily disciplines that you've brought into your life, and which is actually part of why I've written the Perspective, you know, study guide. It takes about 10 minutes a day just to read from here. But talk to us about your disciplines. You talked about the promises of God. What are some of those promises that you remind yourself of every day?
One of them is that God is faithful to complete what he started in me. I hold on to that one.
He's faithful to complete what he started in you.
Another one is that God says that he's returning the years, the locus of anger.
What does that mean?
I mean, I feel like I lost a lot of years in addiction, in brokenness. But I believe that God can restore those years and multiply what I've got. And the things I feel like I lost can come back. He can restore that, you know, and I believe I look at my life right now and I'm like, God, this is really real. Like, he is so faithful. So many things are fired on all cylinders, and I'm excelling and I'm prospering. And it's been a long time that I could say that.
What does prospering mean? Because it sounds like a musician, man. You must have scored a couple million.
Oh, no, not yet. But you know what it is? It's having time with my son. It's living in a beautiful home that God provided for a lot less rent than I was paying before. It's having a car that works and drives me to work and drives me to pick up my son. It's the phone call being calling, people calling to book me.
Although last week, that car that worked so well, I remember you were coming to church as early in the morning. You called me and said you had a blowout.
Yeah. And you know,
but God sent a friend from down the road to fix your tire in 20 minutes.
Yeah, it was so quick. He's faithful. It's so fun. Like, it just, he does more than we can ever hope for or imagine. And it's just his promises. He is faithful. He is faithful. You know, another promise I have is I say I can do hard things, and I say I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And, you know, he gives me the strength to, my schedule is pretty busy, driving all over the place, playing shows with my son, coming to the church, different cities all every day. I drive for hours and hours a day, but he gives me the strength. He sustains me. You know, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. He's not let me down yet. It's not in his nature. He won't start.
Are you tempted ever to go back to the old way of life?
You know what? The devil whispers in my ear every so often. I'm like, get away from me. I'm not going back. Can't. He has been so good. I've tasted and I've seen how good he is. And if people, that's in the Psalms. I read that just the other day. When you taste and see the goodness of Jesus, I'm in less pain. I have less weight. Bills are paid. Healthy relationships. You know, time with my son. I get to inspire and help other people. I feel so grateful.
Tell us about the song Walk on Water.
Walk on water is being disappointed about doing great things and then kind of feeling like you fizzled out. But knowing that God is faithful and saying, God, I'll wait for you to walk water. I'll wait for that miracle. Verse 2 says, I climbed to great heights. I fought many fights, but came dark nights, and I crumbled because I did. Broken and alone, flesh faded to stone until I heard his still voice that was calling me home. And I feel like I've come home, and I'll keep waiting for him to walk on water and show me and bring me out of the boat in faith so I can walk on water with him.
What does that mean for people watching you today saying, well, that's nice for you, but Kristin, you don't know my story?
Well, you know my story. It's not a comparison game, but I tell you what, I don't know many people that if they were as desperate and hopeless as I was. He's changed me. You know, I was addicted to drugs and alcohol and sex. I was broken and angry. And he's healed me. He's set me free. He has put my foot on a rock. He has sustains me. He gives me life. He gives me hope. And I want to share that with people because I was far gone. And he called me. He left the 99 to get me.
Wow.
And I want to tell everybody that they're, it's not too late. Never too late.
Well, let's do that right now. I'm going to let you sing that song. And we're going to listen even more carefully because of the way that you've unpacked it. And we're so excited with what Jesus has done in your life, but also that he died to do that, not only in your life, but he's done it in my life because I was so far away. He'll do it in the lives of others. And if you're watching today, this song is God's message to you.
Take away this storm.
I don't know if you caught what Kristin was saying before he sang that song, but he talked about rehearsing or reminding himself of the promises of God. He had no idea what I was going to teach on today, but if you have ordered a copy of our devotional book, and it's free, we'll send it to you for free, The Perspective, you would read along with us today, and I'm going to teach from it the daily reading, how to get into God's Word, and today's reading actually is on those promises of God. Promises that we can hold on to. So, hey, if you don't have your book, write to us, prayer@theperspective.tv. You can write mike@theperspective.tv, but either of them will work just fine. And give us me your name, your address. We'll mail this out to you. And then you'll also get October's book as it comes along. I hope it'll help you to grow strong. But here are some of the promises. And some of the promises are based upon a way that God wants us to live. Here's the first one, and we're going to read it in Philippians 4. He says, Paul writes from a jail cell, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. And let your reasonableness or your gentleness be known to everyone. Why? The Lord is at hand. And don't be anxious about anything. I need to hear that. But in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. So today's perspective is designed to help you and I know how to pray and to walk in the promises and the power that God wants us to live with. So if you've ever struggled with knowing how to pray, then these four verses that I've read to you have really become a guide, a simple guide for years for Christians throughout the world. But more than a guide, it is really a reflection of how Paul lived his life as a follower of Jesus. Remember, he was in prison. He was on death row when he shares with us his daily practice. Now, I've tried to simplify it, but let's get our head around this together. This is good stuff. It will help you and become a practical guide as you take time every day to pray. Have you thought about that? Starting your day with prayer. You can take this guide. You can take time to read God's Word. There's encouragement there. This will take you about 10 minutes a day, and it'll start your day on the right foot. So here we go. There's a couple things out of this little passage. The first thing Paul says is begin with praise, because rejoicing in the Lord is the language of faith. Start each day with giving thanks to God for what He brings to your mind. And there is lots to be thankful for. There's always a list of things we can gripe about, but start by saying, God, I want to thank you. I want to thank you for today. And then secondly, there's peace. He says, let your gentleness or your reasonableness be known to everyone, which only happens when you surrender each and every part of your day to the Lord. Listen to what he says. The Lord is at hand. Don't be anxious about anything. And that's perspective. You see, as you pray, invite the Lord to give you His perspective on your life. The reminder to us all is that the Lord's return is near. That helps me to keep things in check. Remember, we're citizens of another country, folks. It's called heaven. And that's why He says, don't be anxious. And then He says, pray. And as you pray, do it with a thankful heart. Let that be your statement of faith and your new way of dealing with the stuff of life, saying, you know what, as bleak and as challenging as it seems, I'm going to give thanks to you, God, And I'm going to believe you're going to be with me to guide me through this or to give me the strength to endure. And then there is a promise that we hold on to. An amazing promise is, as we pray with thanksgiving, God's peace will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. Folks, I have proven this principle over and over, and yet I have to be reminded about it over and over again. So as I'm sharing with you, I'm sharing it with myself. Thank God for his peace, for his presence, and claim what is rightfully yours.
And I had a person tell me when I was 11 years old, it was a little morbid at the time, but I didn't really figure it out until I was a little older, but he said, grab a piece of paper and write down what you would want on your headstones. What do you want to be remembered as? And write that out. And then think about how you can spend more days living as that person. That will give you the clarity. And then with the clarity, then you build in steps of what you need to do each day to become that person. And then you determine how you want to impact culture or those around you. How do I live as that person to have that impact? And then what do you want to leave behind? Maybe it's the people, maybe it's a foundation. What do you want to leave behind? Because this is not a dress rehearsal. This life will kill you. We're all in. And at the same time, there's beauty in that. How do we recognize that and structure our lives knowing that we have a limited amount of time and we can't afford to waste it?
Can I encourage you today to apply what you've heard? We think about the song, you know, walking on water and what that means for you and what it means for me. It can be different things, but the common point is this: we have to take a step of faith. We have to look at the situation or we can look at the Savior. And when I'm looking down at the waves that are all around me, oh, I just want to go down. So why not start with one area of your life that you find challenging and thank the Lord for the situation and invite him to reveal himself to you in his power and with his peace. You see, when you invite Jesus into the middle of your life, he will come, but you have to repent of your past and say, Lord, lead me into the new future that you have for me. That's where he wants to take you. And at any time, you can call us at 855-910-6297 or write to us, prayer@theperspective.tv, and let us know how we can be praying for you today. And until tomorrow, I'm Mike Sherbino.